Hello everybody, today we are going to see one important theorem, okay, that is theorem number 8. Already we have seen some important theorem, but this theorem is very much important and already we have seen activity which is related to this, okay. See, what is the statement? The angle subtended by an arc of a circle at the center is double the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so this is the given statement. We have seen the activity. See, figure, three figures are given. Already I have done, I have constructed here figure. Three cases we are going to see. For all the three cases, we are going to see the result is getting same or different. Okay, so see here, construction I have done already, but we need to mention here. Okay, so see once again, the angle subtended by an arc of a circle. The angle subtended by an arc, here we are going to consider an RPQ by an arc of a circle at the center. So PQ is doing angle with center, that is POQ, angle POQ, okay, is double the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. So if you'll observe here first figure, PQ is the arc, okay, and R is any point on the remaining part of the circle. Remaining part means remaining QP, on arc QP, R point is getting given. Okay, so here we have to prove POQ, angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. That is our target. Okay, so see carefully, three cases we are going to see. Very much important theorem, so see carefully everybody. The angle subtended by an arc of a circle at the center, here circle is given, okay. So, here we will write in given, an arc PQ, RPQ. I told you, this is anti-clockwise we are taking, understood? So, from this to this is PQ, RPQ of circle, COR, and R is a point on the remaining part, on the remaining part of the circle, remaining part, that is on QP, on remaining part we can write RQP also, instead of remaining part we can write RQP also, okay. To prove what we have to prove, angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Okay, POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Okay, so construction, before that see carefully, I have done already here construction. Three cases we are going to see. Okay, we have taken RPQ. Okay, when RPQ is minor arc, RPQ is minor arc, RPQ is semicircular, and RPQ is major arc, RPQ is major arc. Like that, three conditions we are going to study. So, first, now we are going to think about the first figure. Before that, we will mention here construction. Okay, so join RO and produce, okay, which will produce it till point M outside of the circle, okay, or here this point we can take anywhere, understood? This you can use here or here also, we can take anywhere we can use, okay. So construction we have done. Now we are going to think about the proof, okay. Three different things we are going to see. So see, first we are going to see case one. In proof we will see case one. Okay, so case first, what we are going to see, carefully see. In triangle POR, this, I am talking about this triangle, POR, POM is the exterior angle. Okay, POM, this is the exterior angle for this triangle. Okay, so in first case, I am taking here, in triangle POR. And we know the exterior angle property. Exterior angle is always equals to the sum of interior opposite angle. This plus this. Okay, exterior angle is always equal to the sum of interior opposite angles. Okay, so I can say here angle POM, angle POM is equal to angle POM is equal to angle OPR, angle OPR plus angle ORP, angle ORP. Getting everybody? Exterior angle is equal to the sum of interior opposite angle, means this plus angle this. Okay, so accordingly we have taken angle POM is equal to angle OPR plus ORP. But if you will observe carefully here, then see OR is also a radius and OP is also a radius. OR and OP are the radius. Okay, means radii of the same circle are always equal. So this and this is equal. So angle opposite of that, angle opposite of equal sides are always same. Okay, so we can say angle ORP is equal to angle OPR. Angle ORP is equal to angle OPR. Okay, angle ORP is equal to, so angle ORP is equal to angle OPR. What is the reason? Because OP is equal to OR. OP and OR are equal. So angle opposite of equal sides are same. So here OPR and ORP are equal. So what I am taking here? This I am using here angle POM is equal to angle OPR. OPR I am replacing by ORP. ORP plus angle ORP. Okay, so here we can say angle POM is equal to ORP plus ORP 2 times angle ORP. Okay, so POM is equal to 2 times angle OR, 2 times angle ORP. Okay, so this we got. So this I am saying this is first one. Okay, so now we will think about the second triangle, that is triangle ORQ. Okay, so now ORQ or QOR. Okay, so in triangle QOR, see this is exterior angle. For this triangle, this is exterior angle, and exterior angle here we need to write reason also, exterior angle property, or whole statement also we can use here. Understood? So in triangle QOR, what we can say, in triangle QOR, angle QOM, angle QOM is equal to, QOM is equal to ORQ, angle ORQ plus angle OQR, angle OQR. But here also the same thing, OQ and OR are the radii of the same circle and both the radii are equal. So angle opposite of equal sides are always same. So this and this is equal. Understood? So we can say ORQ, angle ORQ is equal to angle OQR, because OQ is equal to OR, radii of the same circle. So here we can use this angle QOM is equal to angle ORQ, ORQ plus this also I am replacing by ORQ, angle ORQ. Okay, so angle QOM is equal to ORQ plus ORQ is equal to 2 times angle ORQ. So this I am saying second one. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are going to add both the equations, equation 1 and equation 2. So by adding equation 1 and, okay, so equation 1 is angle POM plus angle QOM is equal to two times angle ORP plus two times angle ORQ. Okay, so POM plus QOM means what? We can say this plus this means we can say POQ, angle POQ is equal to, we can take 2 common from this. What is going to get 2 in bracket angle ORP plus angle ORQ. ORP, ORP plus ORQ means we can say PRQ, angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Okay, so here we got angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Okay, so hence the result is this. Got it, everybody? This was about case 1. When case 1, what is the case 1? When PQ, RPQ is a minor arc. Minor arc. Okay, when RPQ is a minor arc, that time we have seen this. Okay, now what we are going to see, we are going to think about the second figure. Second figure, when RPQ is a semicircular, RPQ is semicircular. Okay, so now I am taking here only. Okay, so see carefully, case second. Case second, when arc PQ is a semicircular. Okay, semicircular. Okay, so now PQ means it is, PQ is the diameter. PQ is through the center of the circle. PQ is the diameter, so PQ divides into two halves. Okay, so now it is semicircular. So in that case also we are going to see the same thing, same proof is going to come for all the three figures. Okay, so see carefully here, POM, this point is R. Okay, POM is the exterior, POM is the exterior angle. POM is equal to OPR plus ORP. POM is equal to OPR plus ORP. Okay, so here I am taking intraangle POR. POR, intraangle POR, what we are going to say, angle, this is the exterior angle for this triangle. This is exterior angle for this triangle. So angle POM, angle POM is equal to angle OPR, angle OPR plus angle ORP, plus angle ORP. But OP and OR are the radii of the same circle. Understood? So radii of the same circle are equal. Just now we have seen for case 1. Okay. So now, so angle opposite of them are equal. So this and this angle is equal. Okay. So we can say angle OPR is equal to angle ORP. Why? Because OP is equal to OR. OP and OR are equal. So here I am using again this, POM is equal to angle ORP. This I am replacing by ORP. Angle ORP plus angle ORP. Okay. So angle POM is equal to 2 times angle ORP. 2 times angle ORP. So this is, I am saying, first one. Okay, now we will think about triangle ORQ. In triangle ORQ, what is going to get here? This is the exterior angle. This angle is exterior angle for this triangle. So QOM, angle QOM is equal to, QOM is equal to angle OQR, angle OQR plus angle ORQ, angle ORQ. But this and this angle are equal. So here we can say angle OQR plus angle ORQ. Oh, sorry, both angles are equal. ORQ. Why? Both angles are equal because OR and OQ are the radii of the same circle. So here we can give reason, OR is equal to OQ. OR and OQ are same. So we can here replace by angle QOM. Angle QOM, we can write QRO, ORQ, this I am replacing by ORQ, angle ORQ plus angle ORQ. So here we can say angle QOM is equal to 2 times angle ORQ. Okay, so this is, I am saying, second one. Now by adding again 1 and 2, by adding 1 and 2. Okay, what is first one? Angle POM, LHS of first one plus angle QOM is equal to 2 times angle ORP plus 2 times angle ORQ. So POM plus QOM. POM plus QOM means what? POM, angle POM, that is 180 degree, is equal to 2 times, 2 we can take common, what is going to remain in bracket? Angle ORP, ORP plus angle ORQ. So this angle plus this means what? PRQ. So angle POM is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. POM is equal to POM plus QOM. Sorry, POM plus QOM is POQ. Here POQ will come. POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. So we got second result also for the second case. When PQ is the semicircular. PQ is semicircular. Now third case we are going to see. When PQ is a major arc. When PQ is a major arc. That also we are going to see. And for this also the result is same. And the same figure and explanation is also same. Only arc PQ is a major arc. Okay. So we are going to see that also. So see carefully. Okay, now case third, when RPQ is major arc, okay, RPQ is a major arc, we are going to use here figure number 3, okay, when PQ is a major arc, okay, so now we are going to think about this triangle PRO and QRO. Okay, so in triangle PRO, this is the exterior angle. This is exterior angle, and this angle is equal to sum of interior angle, interior opposite angle. So just now we have seen the same explanation. OPR is equal to angle OPR plus ORP, angle ORP, okay, OPR and ORP are equal, OPR and ORP are equal because these are the radii of the same circle. So directly I am taking here angle PO, here this is M, POM in triangle PRO, we are going to use angle POM is equal to ORP and OPR, angle ORP plus angle OPR, but these both angles are equal. Now I am not writing here explanation, okay, already we have given 2 times. So here we can write angle POM is equal to 2 times angle ORP, 2 times angle ORP. Okay, ORP. This is I am saying first one. The same thing. Second, now we will think about triangle ORQ. In triangle ORQ. Okay, ORQ. Angle QOM is equal to angle ORQ. This angle, this is exterior angle is equal to sum of interior angles. So ORQ and angle OQR. Again, these two angles are same. So here I am taking directly angle QOM is equal to 2 times angle QRO or ORQ. Angle 2 times angle ORQ. Because this and this angle is same. So this is second one. This is first one. Again, by adding first and second. So angle POM plus angle QOM is equal to directly I am taking two common, angle ORP, ORP plus angle ORQ. POM, POM plus QOM means what? POQ. Angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle ORP. ORP and ORQ means what? PRQ. Angle PRQ. So, we have received in all the three cases the same result. POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Okay, so we have seen both the sides. This result we have seen practically also. Okay, with the help of activity. And now with the theoretically, means with the help of theorem also we have seen this angle. Okay, angle arc subtended with the center, angle which is subtended by the arc with the center is double the angle which is subtended on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so we have seen the same result in three cases, minor arc, semicircular and major arc. We have received all the in all the three cases same result. Okay, and which is very much important theorem. So, see carefully and solve this in your notebook. Okay, see here, our second property is, next property, the angle in a semicircle is right angle. The angle in a semicircle is right angle. Already we have seen one example. In that example, we have directly taken angle in the semicircle is 90 degree. That time I told you. Okay, now we are going to see why angle in the semicircle is a right angle. Okay, so see here, the statement angle in the semicircle is right angle. So here given, what is given? In circle COR, okay, COR, what is given? PQ is the diameter. PQ is diameter. Understood? Due to PQ, this circle is divided into two equal parts. Okay, equal or halves, we can say. So PQ is diameter. So this is POQ is a straight angle, which is 180 degree that we are going to use in the proof. Okay, and what we have to prove here? To prove angle in the semicircle. So here PRQ, angle PRQ is, here you can write it, angle PRQ is in semicircle. Angle PRQ is in semicircle. Okay, so here we can say, PRQ, here what we have to prove, angle PRQ is equal to 90 degree, that we need to prove. Okay, and this is very simple. Just now we have seen theorem number 8, okay, which is important. On that basis we are going to give this proof. Okay, so here we can say angle, this is an arc, RPQ, okay, it subtends angle in the center, that is POQ. Okay, and POQ will be twice of angle PR. POQ is equal to twice of angle PR. Okay, just now we have seen. Okay, so what we can say, angle in triangle POQ in triangle PRQ. In triangle, here proof. In triangle PRQ. We can say POQ, angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. 2 times angle PRQ. What is the reason? Angle, here we need to write the whole statement. Angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle which is subtended by the same arc on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so with the help of that we can say POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. But here angle POQ is a straight angle, and straight angle is always equal to 180 degree. So here we can replace this one 180 degree. 180 degree is equal to 2 times angle PR. So PRQ angle PRQ is equal to 180 divided by 2. 180 divided by 2 is 90. And that was our target. Angle PRQ is equal to 90 degrees. So this is very simple sum. These properties, the case here, or theorem number 9, which is also very much important. What is that theorem? See, angles in the same segment of a circle are equal. Okay, angles in the same segment of a circle are equal. Okay, here figures are given. Same segment. You see, this is PQ. PQ. Okay, and this is also POQ. POQ. Same segment. So PRQ and PSQ are the angles which are in the same segment. Okay, which are in the same segment. Here also the same thing. PRQ and PSQ are in the same segment. Okay, so for both the figures we are going to see. Okay, so now see, in given, angles in the same segment. What is given? Circles are given. In circle COR, okay, PRQ angle. PRQ and angle PSQ are in the same segment. Okay, both angles are in the same segment. Okay, now what we have to prove? To prove angles in the same segment of a circle are equal, we have to prove angle PRQ and angle PSQ are equal. So, angle PRQ is equal to angle PSQ. Angle PRQ and angle PSQ are equal, that we need to show. Okay, so here we need to do some construction. What is that construction? Already I have done with dotted line, that is the construction we need to do. Okay, construction: join OP and OQ in both the figures. Okay, so join OP and OQ. Now we will think about the proof. So first we will think about the first figure. Okay, in first figure, what we have seen? This is PQ is an arc, subtended angle in the center. So we can say POQ angle angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ. Okay. Second, also we can say angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PSQ. Okay, what is the reason? Why POQ? Because see, R and S are the two points on the remaining part of the circle. R and S are the two points on the remaining part of the circle, or on the RQB. Okay, so with the help of this we can say POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ and POQ is equal to 2 times angle PSQ. Okay, so here what is the reason? Angle, the same reason, angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle, subtended by it on the remaining part, of the circle. Okay, so this is the statement. You will write 3-4 times, then you can write the statement properly. Okay, so POQ, and this is with the help of this is, I am saying first one and this is second one. So from first and second, two values we have. POQ is equal to 2 times angle PRQ, POQ is equal to 2 times angle PSQ. So with the help of this we can say 2 times angle PRQ is equal to 2 times angle PSQ. 2 will be cancelled, so angle PRQ is equal to angle PSQ, and that was our target. Okay, so we got it. Now we will think about this second figure. Okay, the reason is same. Now reflex angle of POQ. POQ is equal equal to 2 times angle, same reason, 2 times angle PRQ, 2 times angle PRQ. Replace angle POQ is equal to 2 times angle PSQ. PSQ, this we are thinking about second figure. Okay, so this is I'm saying first and second. By first and second, you can say reason will be same. The same statement will be there. 2 times angle PRQ is equal to 2 times angle PSQ. Okay, so angle PRQ is equal to angle PSQ. Okay, so we got in both the figures we got the same result. Okay, and this is very much important. Angle, today we have seen three theorems. Okay, angle is subtended by an arc with the center is double the subtended on the remaining part of the circle. That is one result we have seen. Angle in the semicircle is right angle, that is second. And third one, angles in the same segment of a circle are equal. Okay, so all the three properties and theorems are very much important for class 10th, 11th, 12th. Okay, so see carefully and solve the same theorems in your notebook. Thank you.